I told her that I was in love with her. And she rejected me. She said that she didn't feel the same way about me. So I left.
Did you ever stop to think that maybe she was just scared?
Yes.
I think she committed suicide.
You should seek closure with your dad. I hope the money helps. I had a decent gig last night. Whatever you decide to do, I wish you luck. Take care of yourself.
Where's Dad?
It's Jeremy.
No,
shit.
You shut up. Tell me how to get a hold of him. I'm sick and tired of this shit. You never give me anything, and now I'm just asking how to get a hold of my father. Now fucking tell me.
Thank you. I'm Kayla Marshall, and I just got done with a 27-month stay in Africa, in the Peace Corps. And it was time to come home. Home is a funny word. Funny concept. I wanted her to feel safe with me and be comfortable with our friendship. Home doesn't have to be a place. It can be a person.
Everything I wanted and I thought I could get is gone.
I thought this would all just come to me. What am I supposed to do now? She was the plan.
I was finally honest with her and myself. I am not who I wish I was. I am the stranger.
Let's talk about some things I have in this fancy room that I have here. One, see these wings? Spent a lot of money on them. Guess who broke them? Kayla. Thanks a lot. Remember when you broke these wings?
I don't know what you're talking about.
These ones.
Nope. I don't see.
She broke them. She broke them because she doesn't appreciate the good things in life, like wings. Two, I have a second thing. This might say that it was $5.99, but it's broken. Oops. You can call me Rachel Bear.
Rachel Bear.
So, Rachel's dead.
I couldn't stand to tell you Rachel was dead. Not because I was mad or bitter over your feelings, but because deep down I saw it coming.
I was looking for Rachel Perkins.
I read her blog. I'm not stupid.
No one told you? Rachel passed away.
On Thanksgiving, she looked terrible.
We found her here.
She went through a lot of shit after you left.
She moved.
A few weeks before it happened, she began giving her things away.
And when I heard she was gone, I wasn't even surprised. All I know is that I can never forgive myself for abandoning my sister.
I'm alone in the world.
Are you? So am I, really.
I didn't want you to love her. I didn't want her to love you. I wanted that. Rachel always told me to never say sorry and to just be honest. I've waited so long to tell you how I feel that now I don't even know how to feel. Rachel is gone. And I don't even think I'm a good substitute. She always said that you can never go home again. Your home is not in your mom. It's not in your dad. It's not in me. Sure as hell wasn't in Rachel. You left us all a long time ago.
I just took off. I ran away from the fire and from jon-michael and from wherever the fuck Rachel was. I didn't see Rachel again for the rest of the summer. And that field that caught fire. Never grew back.
Hey, Kayla.
That's not you lying on the ground, just a figure in a photograph I found. That's not the man I used to know, just a shadow hidden in a mess of crows. Clouded by the mess of the road, books full of pages of what we don't know. We're grounded by what we won't change, bound by the fear of coming days. Won't you wake me? Try to sleep past me. Won't you walk out with quietly? Won't you let me sleep? Won't you let me sleep?
Music in this episode by Sterling Johnson.
You walk out quietly.
Bobie.